unless they all stop what they're doing, they cannot figure out how he does it. Setting up for the big barnstormers, the first aerobatic maneuver ever in that. Roll as we get a little flame out the bottom of that engine, a little of the John Mohr showbiz. 4-point hesitation roll, where in a slow roll he stopped the airplane no less than 4 times every 90 degrees of rotation. Now, Captain Mohr started his airline career in the mid-70s as well. He was a Czech airman for the airline that he flew for. He's going to double the difficulty factor, stopping every 45 degrees with 4. There's 5.
Now, we're going to have power. We'll be setting up for repositioning current. Now, you know, on the big axis, where we had a good difficulty, let's try that in slow motion. So John said, we're all a slow
slow as he possibly can go without stopping, and we call that maneuver the gotcha maneuver. It's done at every one of John's shows, and we got you. I heard you. How about a big round of applause for John Mohr? Part of the reason he won those showmanship awards, and part of the reason nobody flies this type of airplane like the great John Mohr. You've heard me say it so many times. I don't want to repeat myself, but he is the maestro. All right, now, setting up for maneuver with some altitude called the reverse Cuban 8. Now, the reverse Cuban 8, instead of starving, the maneuver is a dive and it's coming up. To the left. That's how you get into a hammerhead turn. A quarter roll on the way up, that rudder coming in all the way back, and then reversing direction from straight up, straight down. By the way, the French and the British call that maneuver the vertical reverse. We call it the hammerhead. It is the same, very same maneuver. All right, aerobatic maneuvers are a variation of some basic maneuvers. what John does, Mr. Wharton, John Mohr, okay.